Hello students, today we will discuss cell in MSc previous biology. The topic is cell structure and functions. Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life. All living organisms consist of cell or cells. Life cannot exist in any substance or thing which is non-cellular. A cell is a self-contained unit and can act as an autonomous unit. A cell is capable of carrying out all basic biological processes such as nutrition, respiration, reproduction, excretion, and metabolism. All living organisms consist of cells. Some consist of cells only. In multicellular organisms, the cells are specialized for particular functions. Cells in these organisms therefore form similar groups. This group, which contains all the cells similar in origin, structure and functions, is called a tissue. Cell theory. The cell was discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665. Since then, several discoveries regarding the structure and function of cell have been made. In the same direction, in 19th century, a German botanist, Matthias Jakob Schleiden, and a German zoologist, Theodor Schwann, proposed basic understanding of the cell and its nature. This is popularly known as cell theory. Later on, in the light of modern discoveries and work of many scientists, especially Rudolf Virchow, modern theory was established. Salient feature of modern theory are: cell is the basic structure and function unit of life. Cell is the smallest unit in which life can exist. All living beings are composed of cell. Each cell consists of protoplasmic mass containing a nucleus and surrounded by a cell membrane with or without a cell wall. A cell is able to maintain its vitality and individuality. All cells are closely similar in their structure, chemical composition, and basic activities. A cell can not arise de novo. New cell always arises from pre-existing cells. A cell can be specialized to perform a particular function according to the need of the individual. A cell contains all the required information in the form of genetic material. All present-day cells have a common origin as they have arisen from a single cell that was evolved for the first time on the earth. Now the features common to all cells. There is a great biodiversity. Different organisms have different types of cells. Even all cells of an individual are not the same. Nevertheless, all cell types have some functional common features. These are: all cells have genetic material. All cells have a definite boundary or cell membrane. The structure of cell membrane is same in all cells. Synthesis of nucleus, nucleic acid and proteins occur on exactly similar plane. Cells have exactly the same genetic codes. All cells transmit genetic information to its successor cells. All cells are totipotent in some stages of their life span. Exchange of energy, material and basic metabolic processes are also same. another point is size and shapes of cells. Size of different cells varies greatly. Smallest known cell is PPLO, belonging to Mycoplasma group. Viruses are the smallest creatures, however, they are not cellular. The largest cell is the ostrich egg. Eggs have reserve food material, hence generally they have larger size. Simultaneously, the shapes of different types of cells is different. To suit the body conditions and meet the demand of the individual, the cell undergo a change in their shape. For example, human nerve cell is the longest cell of the body. It is specialized for the conduction of impulses, hence it has modified itself accordingly by developing processes like axon and dendrites. Similarly, RBCs are very small. This small shape helps to increase surface area. This helps in the perfect oxygenation of hemoglobin. Now, another point is prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Cells are of different types broadly on the basis of presence or absence of nucleus. Cells are of two types, A, prokaryotic cell, and B, eukaryotic cells. First type is prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells are very primitive cells characterized by the absence of a true nucleus and membrane-bound organelles. These are represented by bacteria, mycoplasma, spirochetes and rickets, etc. Important features of prokaryotic cells. Absence of a true nucleus, pro-primitive karyon nucleus. Absence of nuclear membrane, therefore there is no differentiation of protoplasm into cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. The genetic material lies in the cytoplasm. Other membrane-bound organelles such as Golgi complex, ER and mitochondria, etc. are also absent. The ribosomes are of 70s types. Cell wall does not contain cellulose. Instead, it contains peptidoglycan units. Genetic material is represented by a single circular DNA molecule. Besides main DNA, some extra chromosomal DNA is also present. It is called plasmid. Plasma membrane forms infoldings called mesosomes, which are associated with energy production. This is the diagram of a typical prokaryotic cell. This is the cell wall. This is the cell wall. This is cell membrane. This is flagellum. Main DNA, plasmids. Main DNA, it is also known as chromosomes. Plasmids, they are extra chromosomal DNA units. So this is a diagram of a typical prokaryotic cell. On the second, cells are, they are known as eukaryotic cells. These are well developed and advanced cells. These have true nucleus. These cells also possess membrane-bound organelles. Except bacteria and mycoplasma, all organisms contain eukaryotic cells. Important features of eukaryotic cells. Nucleus is conspicuous, surrounded by a double-walled true nuclear membrane. DNA and genetic material is located inside the nucleus. DNA is associated with histone proteins. DNA consists of intervening non-coding and coding regions. Ribosomes are usually attached to ER. Ribosomes are of 80s type, which consists of 40s and 60s subunits. Mitochondria are present where energy production occurs. Membrane-bound organelles such as Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, plasmids, etc. are present. Centrioles are also present. So, this is the diagram of eukaryotic cell. In this eukaryotic cell, there is a nucleus in the center of the cell. There is a mitochondria, chloroplast, plasma membrane, lysosomes, cytoplasm, vacuoles, cell wall, etc. Now, the differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells, nucleus ill-developed or absent. In eukaryotic cells, well-developed nucleus. In prokaryotic cells, nuclear membrane absent, nuclear membrane present. Genetic material lies in cytoplasm as nucleotides. Genetic material lies in nucleoplasm. Membranous organelles like mitochondria, plastids, Golgi, ER are absent. All are present. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. Absent or present? When present, never contains peptidoglycan. Ribosomes are of 70s types with 30s and 50s subunit. Ribosomes are of 80s type with 40s and 60s subunits. Cilia, flagella when present have 9 arrangement of microtubules. Cilia, flagella when present have 9 plus 2 arrangement of microtubules. DNA is not associated with histone proteins. DNA is associated with histone forming nucleoplasm units. Extra chromosomal DNA is usually present. Such material is not present. This is all about in cell structure and function.